Hello, everybody. Today we're flying the Mark 5 Spitfire. Mark 5B, as a matter of fact. Number 524. Very nice looking Mark 5. So we're just going to fly around the countryside and the water, probably just a little offshore, take a look at some ships, and then we'll be coming back here. So let's go ahead and get her started. So the crew chief's got her all cranked up already, ready to go. No armaments, no extra fuel tanks, just a quick little sortie offshore. Okay, we're all strapped in and ready to go. Let's go ahead and taxi out. Mark 5 Spitfire. Very, very versatile during the war. It could do a lot of things. Didn't hold much ammo, that's for sure. Not a whole lot of guns, but it could carry bombs, it could carry missiles. And it was available for all kinds of roles. So yeah, very versatile. Engineers are doing some runway work. Some flaps in. Check the altimeter. Get the compass straight. Okay. Let's boogie. like a wild rabbit. Modeled out pretty well. I actually do like the interior. I mean, it's not super duper great, but I mean, that's pretty well detailed out. And the cool thing about it is a lot of these switches are all usable, which is cool because it makes you utilize a lot of things that you really should be doing when you're flying this particular plane. He's looking pretty damper in there, and he's got his O2 gas mask, or O2 mask on.
Looking forward.
Pretty smooth, I must say. my brother's got an interesting air intake in the front, almost reminiscent of the Hawkers. I don't know how many times I can get away while doing this, because this particular scenery mod usually says goodbye to me after a couple crazy flybys like that. France is probably, it's a pretty good country to fly over, and I don't even have the update on here. Doesn't look bad. All right, let's get noisy. Yeah, so we got to get her down below 160 to get these flaps down safely. There we go. Once they go down, they really break this thing down. I mean, look at that airspeed. It bleeds on fast. There's a breather I was telling you about. Very interesting looking. I did read up on it a little bit, so there was two options that the Mark V had. There's a locally produced air system. And then there was another one, I think was French. I'd have to look it up again. It was actually a word I couldn't pronounce. But, yeah, very interesting. And we'll see if we can get in there without bouncing her and, ground with them. Those are some narrow wheels. Pretty much similar to a measure split. this is my second landing with this plane. My first one was not bad, but a little bouncy. And the reason being was I came in too hot. I know one thing, when you pull the power off this thing, she drops like a rock. Take it. She wanted to drop that one wing. I'll take it. Love the sound. That engine. There's a little bit of backfiring going on there. Gotta love it. And I'll tell you what, this is the cheapest one on the marketplace, and you get quite a few liveries, some really nice ones, tropical, I think it's French, RAF. Gotta love Spitfire though, you know. It's kind of like having a J3 Cub too. You gotta have the classics. And I didn't really see myself buying one, but I had the P40, which I love. That thing flies just really nice. Oh, you know what? The mixture is really in a strange place. It's over here. How about that, huh? There's the battery kill. So anyway, I hope you like that flight, and I hope you like this airplane, because I do. I'm really happy and really pleased with it. I'm going to have some fun, that's for sure. I'll talk to you later.